Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the stream. Starting our session a little bit later than planned this morning. So, today's intervals, you can see there on the screen, Dennis Rue short. So a session for working on attacking over hills and recovering over the top. Because of time constraints, we've reduced the session down a little bit. It should actually be three intervals, and the recovery blocks should be 10 minutes and 20 minutes. But we've reduced them down to 5 and 10 today. So, starting off with a 20 minute warm up, and then we're going straight into VO2 max efforts. That's to simulate attacking up over the hill, paring it down a little bit into zone 3 as we start to recover, and then into zone 2 endurance. That'll simulate us down the bottom of the hill, back on the flats, and then ready to start again. Feel free to leave some comments, get involved in the chat, or better still, jump on Swift, select ride with, and come along for the fun. So this is day 2 of our 3-day block. Unfortunately, due to some things in the house this morning, not managed to do any stretching yet. So this warm-up's going to be key to getting our legs ready. Feeling a little bit heavy just now. Hopefully we can work that out. So thanks to Dave Owen, resident coach within the KRT team, for coming up with this session. It's going to be quite a toughie. The training blocks this week, we've got a 3-day block, and they're all about high intensity, short, sharp VO2 max efforts. And then when we're recovering, we're going quite low on the recoveries. So really this week's all about returning the pedals. We're either in recovery or we're going hard. Boys trying to distract me there with his monkey, doing a good impersonation. So, Dennis Rue, for those that don't know the cycling history, is an ex-professional cyclist from France. Surname gives it away a little bit. He was late 80s, early 90s, and he was a relatively successful cyclist. It's difficult really to gauge what do you term as success. He certainly had stage victories within the Vuelta. His best ride in the Tour was 10th. I think you would class that as successful in a career. Interesting that Dave should use this name for the title. Ken's Cram, thanks for the follow, appreciate it. Interesting that Dave should use this guy's name for the title of today's session. Like many people my age, early 40s, early, late 80s was my era for watching cycling as a kid, and certainly, although I don't recall Dennis Roux's name at the time, I do certainly remember the teams that he was in, two of which were jerseys that I actually owned as a kid. Unfortunately, I don't have them anymore. One was the Fantastic Z team, amazing jersey, blue with a big yellow Z, like a sort of flash behind it as if it was moving fast. And then the Lavie Clare team, fantastic team, very late, early 90s, had a lot of success. So it's quite interesting that that should be the name of today's session. So, what is this that you're watching? You're coming across this stream live, or if you're watching the VOD afterwards, or it may be on the YouTube channel. So what you're looking at just now is Zwift. Zwift is an online game, essentially, for indoor training. Indoor training for cyclists has always been the thing that you don't really talk about. You know what goes on, a little bit like Fight Club, really. First rule of indoor training, you don't talk about training. Indoor training has always been something that you've needed to do, but something that you really didn't like. The whole beauty of cycling is outdoors, what you see around you. When you're training indoors, you're staring at a wall, you're maybe staring at your power meter figures. It's so boring. But it was essential if you wanted to be successful the next again season. Zwift has come along, they've changed all that. I mean, look at what we're looking at just now. Fantastic graphical representation of an island. Yes, you've got all the power metrics up there. You know, I'm currently doing 190 watts, 86, 89 RPM, 130 beats per minute. That's all getting picked up by sensors. We'll talk about that in a second. So you've still got all that, but you've got a visual representation. You've also got the social aspect. If you look down the right hand side, all these riders are doing exactly the same as me. They're sitting on their bike somewhere in the world. Their bike's connected up to their PC and they're going for a ride. Now, they might be doing a workout, like me. You can see that by the little sort of heads-up display I've got in front of my bike. They might just be out for a ride. Or, there's a huge community of racing that goes on as well. And Zwift has made that accessible to everyone. So what do you need to get hooked up? A bike, obviously, a computer, or most recently, some form of Apple device. So with your bike, you need your smart trainer or a dumb trainer. So a smart trainer is one that's powered. It is able to automatically control the resistance at the back wheel. A dumb trainer would just be a manual one where you control the resistance yourself with a little lever. So if you've got the dumb trainer, you need a speed sensor or possibly a power meter. You've got the smart trainer, you don't need anything else. Connect up to your PC with Ant technology, stick a little dongle in a USB slot, and off you go. The game interprets all that information and then displays what you see on screen. Pretty much the same process if you want to use an Apple device, but with Apple you can actually communicate using Bluetooth technology. Now, like everything in cycling, there's an expensive way of doing things and there's a cheaper way of doing things. If you're watching this and you're interested in it, you might possibly have already come across Shane Miller, the Llama. Down below afterwards I'll link one of his videos. He's done a Zwift setup on a budget, talks you through exactly what you need and how much or how little you can spend to get on it. Good little video, so I'll link that at the bottom after we're finished today's session. So a few minutes left of the warm-up, so let's just talk a little bit about what we're seeing. So in Zwift right now, I'm in a place called Watopia. There's three different locations, and depending on what day of the week you're on, you'll be automatically put into that location, or you can do a little hack, but we'll talk about that in another video. So Watopia Island, it's based on a real island. Obviously the mapping is artificial, these roads don't exist, but the landscape, the topography is real. So we've got a flat route, hilly route, we've got an epic mountain climb, and we've got a volcano extension. So we've got four different routes. You can do them all in reverse. So technically, eight different routes that you can cycle on. Then we've got Richmond, the UCI World's course. And then we have segments of London to make up the Prudential Ride London course, roundabout central London. And then with a little bit of artistic license through the tube system, we can end up in the Surrey Hills. And these are all locations in game which add to the beauty of Zwift, keep it interesting. Regular Zwift users are always clamouring for more information about when new upgrades are coming or new routes. Apparently there might be another one coming soon, which is a climb up the outside of the volcano. So that'll give you five routes within Watopia Island. But we just have to keep our fingers crossed that it's coming soon and try and be patient. Okay, so a couple minutes left. There's not going to be much talking from now on. What we've got coming up is a 4.5 minute block, 350 watts. Now for me, my FTP is 320. So that's the functional threshold power, the power that I can hold realistically for an hour. So 350 watts, it's above threshold. So 4.5 minutes, it's gonna hurt. That obviously signifies getting up that mountain. Then we've got 5 minutes, 290 watts. That's signifying coming over the top, cresting down the other side. And then 10 minutes on the flat, back down, 210 watts. And then we repeat that once. As I said at the beginning, we're a bit tight for time today. The full session would be three repeats of that. The 5 minute block would be 10, and the 10 minute block would be 20. And just one last thing. On the VO2 section, we've got an element which you can't see just now, and that's 30 seconds. I believe it's set at 450, and that's just the final push to get over that top of the climb. So a minute to go, the legs are feeling rather heavy from yesterday, so we'll see how we get on. Thank you. Okay, here we go. Gotta be careful there, watch the power. Just edging a little bit too high. We don't want to overcook it. Legs filling now, full of lactic acid, screaming at you. Heart rate's pumping, trying to get more blood into those legs, more oxygen, help the cells work. Gotta keep focused, get right the way to the end. The harder we work, the stronger we become. Oh boy! Coach! Oh my god! Maybe should have paid a bit more attention there. That 30 second sprint. It wasn't obviously 400, 450, 560. Wow! Now that hurt. So, now I see why the recovery was 10 and 20 and not 5 and 10, but it is what it is. We don't have enough time to do the full session today. We've still got another 40 minutes to go, and to be honest, that's 20 minutes too much for what we've got available today. So we'll do what we can, but time to get focused. Try and get back up to that 290 watts, otherwise we'll fail this block. So, headphones off, because they're super hot. If you're doing this, watching it back, just focus on your breathing. Try and get that heart rate down. Start the recovery as soon as you can. Keep the legs going. Try and maintain those watts. If you can't, that's fine. As long as you're always moving, always breathing, I'm trying to focus on keeping good form on the bike and starting the recovery ready for the next hit. Not surprising, we failed that last block. Too much the first couple of minutes. We were way below the 290. So for me, with a threshold of with an FTP of 320, 290 would be classed as sweet spot. So if you were recreating this workout, you've got the 4.5 minutes, 350. So you're looking at, what's that, 120%? So VO2 max, followed by 30 seconds flat out, full speed, full sprint, 10 minutes, sweet spot. So looking at about 90% of FTP. And then the 10 minutes here I'm doing, if you're doing the full one, do 20 minutes, zone two, so for me, 210. If you want to recreate this workout, again, that's what it looks like. You're doing a 20 minute warm up and then 4.5 minutes above threshold, 30 seconds flat out, 10 minutes sweet spot, 20 minutes zone two endurance, and then repeat. And if you've got the full amount of time, do three sets of that. That should take you just under, 2.5 hours, 2 hours 40, with a 10 minute cool down at the end. Great view there of the Trek Madon in team colours, the KRT kit designed by the fabulously talented Carol Tower, freelance designer coming out of Canada. For those that are in the stream or watching the replays back that don't know about Zwift, so I talked at the beginning about the gamification of online training. So like many games, Zwift has levels. The more miles you do, the more miles we do, the more experience you get, you go up levels. Every level you go up, you get something new, whether that's a bike, a set of wheels, a new kit to use. And each bike, each set of wheels has different characteristics within the game. Some are lighter, some are more aerodynamic, and that's the beauty of Zwift as well, is the designers have programmed in algorithms which look at the weight, the height of your rider, and then therefore the drag against your rider, and then you can alter those figures by selecting different pieces of kit as well. for those elite road snobs, and let's admit it, we all have at least one in our clubs, that are looking at this and thinking, well, okay, that's all fair, but come on, that speed is nonsense. Putting out 190 watts and doing 30 kph. Yep, the speed isn't accurate to real world. The power is, but you've got to remember, there is no rolling resistance. There's no wind resistance. Yeah, they've tried to put algorithms in place, but they still can't accurately say what your speed would be. But they've done a pretty good job, you have to admit. So, just under 2 minutes, and we're on for the next one. We're going to have to skip some here because we are very, very quickly running out of time. I think what's likely is we'll do the 4.5 minutes plus the 30 second sprint, and then we'll jump ahead to the cool down. What's that, 5, 10 minutes? Yeah, we can manage another 10 minutes. Unfortunately, we can't manage another 25. So, sorry about that, folks. But you have seen it once. You don't really need to see all the interval again. Now you can go off and recreate it yourself.
Just to explain what happened there at the end of that workout. If you're watching along the stream, you'll see that everything just went dead. It all cut off. So these headphones I was wearing today, they got caught in my pedals as I went for the sprint. That yanked everything off the desk down here, and that meant that the PC reset itself. So Swift went, the stream went, my temper went. No, seriously though, everything shut itself down, so that's why there was an abrupt end to the video. So anyway, up here there'll be some more videos for you to have a look at. On the other side there's the little icon for subscribing to the channel. It'd be really good if you could. Give me a thumbs up, put some comments down below, all that type of stuff. And I hope you enjoyed today's session, and I'll catch up with you next week for some more Zwift workouts. Right on.